إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him as He deserves to be praised. And we seek His aid and His forgiveness. And we ask His assistance. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of our souls and from the evil of our wicked actions. Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides, then none can misguide. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to misguide, then none can guide. I testify that none has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, without any partners. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and his messenger. To proceed. Insha'Allah ta'ala, ikhwan, today for the khutbah I will read from a very beneficial piece of work that was written by a Shaykh al-Allama al-Sa'di rahmatullahi alayhi, and it is entitled Risalatun fil hathi ala ijtima'i kalimat al-muslimin, concerning the unity of the Muslims. وَذَمِّ التَّفَرُّقِ وَالِاخْتِلَافِ, and the prohibition of splitting and differing. And this is something that is very important and something that we call to and something that we promote. However, in light of the Quran and the Sunnah, with the understanding of the Salaf. And as-Sa'di rahimahullahu ta'ala, he said, concerning the topic of ijtima'u kalimat al-muslimin, the unity of the Muslims, and the prohibition of splitting and differing, he said, rahmatullahi alayhi, fa min a'zam al-awamir al-ilahiyya, wa shara'i' al-samawiyya, wal wasaya al-nabawiyya, الاعتصام بحبل الله جميعا. From the greatest of the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the divine commands and His divine legislations, and also from the prophetic advice and directions, is ماذا, is to cling to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of you together. واتفاق كلمة المسلمين واجتماعهم وائتلافهم, and likewise for the Muslims to be united and to come together and for them to be in a state of harmony. والحث على هذا بكل طريق موصل إليه من الأقوال والأعمال, and likewise the encouragement to achieve this through any lawful legislated means by way of speech and action. وَالتَّعَاوَنْ عَلَى ذَلِكَ, and to cooperate upon this and to achieve this. قَوْلًا وَفِعْلًا, through our speech and through our actions. وَالنَّهِ عَنِ التَّفَرُّقِ وَالِاخْتِلَافِ, and the prohibition. This is also demonstrated through the prohibition of splitting and differing and the division of the Muslims. Barakallahu fikum. He said, وَزَجْرْ عَنْ جَمِيعِ الطُّرُقْ الْمُوصِلَ إِلَيْهِ بِحَسْبِ الْقُدْرَةِ وَالْإِمْكَانِ, and also the prevention of anything that leads to this splitting and this differing, as much as feasibly possible. وقد دل على هذا الأصل العظيم الكتاب والسنة وإجماع الأنبياء والمرسلين. نعم, he said, and this has been established. وقد دل على هذا الأصل العظيم, and this foundation, this great foundation of what? اجتماع كلمة المسلمين, the unity of the Muslims, and the prohibition of splitting and differing, has been established by the Quran and by the Sunnah and the consensus of the prophets and the messengers and their followers until the Day of Judgment. As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, قال تعالى آمرا عباده بالتمسك بحبله الذي هو دينه بالاجتماع عليه ناهيا لهم عن التفرق والاختلاف. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, commanding his servants to hold on and to cling to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his rope, which is his religion. وَهُوَ دِينُهُ. And Allah azza wa jal commanded us to unite upon his religion. And he prohibited them from differing and splitting. And he mentioned his blessing upon them as he granted them success in achieving this unity. And brothers and sisters, we will clarify insha'Allah ta'ala later on what unity is As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala referring to. How is this unity manifested? What are the dawabit, the guidelines for this unity? As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned the saying of Allah azza wa jal, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ حَقَّ تُقَاتِهِ. O you who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He deserves to be feared. وَلَا تَمُوتُنَّ إِلَّا وَأَنْتُمْ مُسْلِمُونَ. And do not die except in a state of al-Islam, except as Muslims. وَاَعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. And hold on, all of you, to the rope of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together, and do not be divided. وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And remember the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon you. إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. As at one point you were enemies and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala joined your hearts. فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. And it was by the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal that you became brothers. إخوان. الشيخ الفوزان حفظه الله تعالى, he said, وَلَا يَحْصُلِ الْإِجْتِمَاعِ. It is impossible for this unity to materialize. It is not feasible to attain this unity. There is no benefit unless ماذا? Unless it is based upon the Quran and the Sunnah. Unless it is based upon ماذا? The correct Islamic creed. The Shaykh, he said, وَلَا يَحْصُلُ الْإِجْتِمَاعِ. It is impossible for any unity to materialize between the mushrik and the muwahid, the one who is upon shirk and the one who is upon a tawheed. And between the sunni, the shaykh, he said, the person upon the sunnah and the mubtadi', the innovator. هَذَان نَقِيدَان لَا يَجْتَمِعَان. These are two opposites which you cannot bring together. التوحيد وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship me alone. التوحيد, which is the key to paradise. التوحيد, which is the key to success. التوحيد, which is the basis for all that is good in this life and the hereafter. Whereas a shirk is the total opposite. وَمَن يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ Whoever associates partners with Allah, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ Allah will prevent them from entering paradise. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ Allah will never forgive that partners be associated with Him, but He forgives lesser than that for those whom He wills. A shirk, if someone dies upon it, major shirk, then they are destined for their hellfire for eternity. And they will never leave it. A sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, I have left you with two things. As long as you hold unto them, you will never go astray after me. The book of Allah and my sunnah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْبَيْضَىٰ I have left you upon clear guidance. لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا Its night is like its day. يعني it's clear. The sunnah is wadiha, bayina, for those who want to implement it and follow it. لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكُ No one deviates from this sunnah except that they are destroyed. The sunnah about which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam he said, مَنْ رَغِبَ عَنْ سُنَّتِي فَلَيْسَ مِنِّي Whoever turns away from it, whoever dislikes it, then they are not from me. Whereas bid'ah is what? كُلُّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ All innovation is misguidance. And all misguidance is ماذا? Is in the hellfire. The Prophet ﷺ, during the sermon, and even the sermon of marriage, what did the Prophet ﷺ used to say? The best speech is ماذا? The speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The best guidance is the guidance of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The most evil of all affairs are newly invented matters in the religion. And all newly invented matters are considered to be innovations, bid'ah. And all innovations are misguidance, and all misguidance is in the hellfire. Can you have unity upon that, ikhwan? There is no unity upon bid'ah. And that's why Shaykh al-Fawzani said, وَلَا يَحْصُلَ الْإِجْتِمَاعِ بَيْنَ السُنِّ وَالْمُبْتَدِعِ There is no unity that will materialize between the person on the sunnah and the person who is an innovator. هَذَا لَا يَحْصُلْ As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he continued, Ikhwan, talking about the importance of unity. He said, قَالَ تَعَالَ نَاهِيًا عَنِ التَّنَازُعِ وَالِاخْتِلَافِ مُخْبِرًا أَنَّهُ سَبَبًا لِلْفَشَلِ وَعَدْمِ النَّصَرِ As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, prohibiting us from disputes and differing and informing us that this is a means of failure and defeat. Na'am. Differing and splitting and quarreling and arguing is a means and a way of what? Failure. And being deprived of success and victory, defeat. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He said, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا And do not differ. فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذَهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ Because you will lose courage, you will fail, and your strength will disappear. نعم إخوان As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, وَقَالَ مُذَكِّرًا عِبَادَهُ بِنِعْمَتِهِ أَلَّتِي لَا يَقْدِرْ عَلَيْهَا إِلَّا الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ And Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, Ikhwan, reminding us of his blessing that only he, the mighty and the all-wise, has the ability to bestow. What is this blessing? Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ And Allah Azza wa Jal, he joined their hearts. Naam, only Allah Azza wa Jal can join our hearts. And Allah Azza wa Jal will join our hearts when we submit to His commands, when we hold onto His rope, which is the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, with the understanding of the Salaf. لو أنفقت ما في الأرض جميعا ما ألفت بين قلوبهم If you were to spend everything in the earth, you would never be able to join their hearts. Never. Allah Azza wa Jalla is informing us of this. Because money will come to an end. Or look what happens. When money is involved, people want more. Or people start to plot against others. So even money will not unite us. Big beautiful, lofty, yani masajid which are muzakhrafa, will not unite us if we're not upon the book and the sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. Nothing will unite us except for this. As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, وَقَالَ ذَامًا لِلْمُنَافِقِينَ بِتَبَاغُدِهِمْ وَتَفَرُّقِ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَلَوْ اجْتَمَعَتْ أَجْسَامُهُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, criticizing the hypocrites because of the division amongst them and the hatred that is between them, even though that they are physically together and united. This is the munafiqoon, ikhwan. They were together with their bodies physically, but in their hearts they hated one another. May Allah Azza wa Jalla protect us all from that. May Allah Azza wa Jalla remove any dislike or hatred towards the people of the sunnah, the people of the haqq, from any heart. From the hearts of the believers. The Shaykh, he mentioned the ayah when Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, تَحْسَبَهُمْ جَمِيعًا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ شَتَّى. You believe that they are together, but their hearts are scattered. Whereas Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, Alhamdulillah, they are together bil-qawli, and they are together with amal. And the one who says other than that, هذا لا يفقه, he does not understand the reality of this matter. What matter is that? اجتماعُ كَلِمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, the unity of the Muslims and the prohibition of splitting and differing. Likewise, As-Sa'di, he said, وَقَالَ جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ, and Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, mentioning his blessing of gentleness upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he blessed the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by granting him tawfiq to be gentle when communicating to the people. الدَّاعِلِ تَأْلِيفِهِمْ, which was a means and a cause for their unity and their harmony and the absence of any type of division. Na'am. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he spoke to the companions, it was with gentleness and it was with kindness. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in the Quran subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ, and it was by the mercy of Allah that you were gentle and that you were kind to them. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَضًّا غَلِيذَ الْقَلْبِ, and if you were harsh to them, they would have fled from you. Subhanallah. Na'am. When we speak to our brothers or our sisters, we should implement the commands of Allah and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because this is from what? Min asbab al-ijtima', this will cause unity and harmony. As-Sa'di, he said, rahimahullah, wa wasaf Allah al-mu'mineen, Allah described the believers. How did he describe the believers and the way that they dealt with one another? Ruhama'u baynahum, they're merciful to one another. They are merciful to one another. They are kind to one another. When they see a brother or a sister in difficulty, they try and assist, not mock or scorn. Hakadha, this is how Allah Azza wa Jal described the believers. As-Sa'di, he said, waqal wa wasafa rasulahu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah described his messenger. How, ikhwan? How? How was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described? Ra'uf al-Rahim. He was compassionate and merciful to the believers. He disliked for any harm to befall them or grief. Are we like this, ikhwan? Do we imitate the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this? Allah Azza wa Jal, he said, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, in the Messenger of Allah is the best example. Ikhwan, don't imitate me. Don't imitate man huwa akbar minni, older than me or younger than me. Don't imitate the person on the right because you hear, so-and-so didn't do that. He didn't do that and he's a student. He didn't do that and he's a scholar. He didn't do that and he has knowledge. She didn't do that and she should know better. No. What did Allah say and what did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say? Our example and role model is who? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If someone agrees with the Prophet, alhamdulillah biha wa ni'mat. If not, then we follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why Sheikh Muhammad Aman al-Jami, he said, we don't give any importance to the statement of a person, no matter yani who they are, if it goes against the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As-Sa'di, he continued, وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah said, talking about unity, ikhwan, unity upon the book and upon the sunnah with the understanding of the salaf. This is a foundation, min al-usul. As-Sa'di referred to it as what? Al-Asl al-Azim. A lofty, great, and important foundation. We're not talking about the unity of Hasan al-Banna, غَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَهُ, which was what? نَجْتَمِعْ فِي مَا اتَّفَقْنَا عَلَيْهِ, we will unite upon that which we agree. وَيَعْذُرُ بَعْضُنَا بَعْضًا فِي مَا اخْتَلَفْنَا فِيهِ, and we will forgive one another about that which we disagree. لَا أَبَدًا, because if that disagreement is concerning aqeedah or is concerning manhaj, we don't overlook that, ikhwan. We're not going to say to you, like some of the deviant sects and firaq and jama'at, they say to you, okay, if you say such about the companions, just don't say it around us. But we're brothers at the end of the day. La, nahnu nubayyin al-batil. We will clarify the truth and inshallah ta'ala refute falsehood. But at the same time, nahnu nureed al-ijtima' al-haq. Listen what As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, ikhwan. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he said, wa ta'awanu ala al-birri wa taqwa, and cooperate upon righteousness and piety. Some of the ulama of al-tafsir, as mentioned by As-Sam'ani rahimahullah, they say this is referring to Islam and the sunnah. Cooperate upon Islam and the sunnah, and do not cooperate upon sin and transgression. They say it's referring to disbelief and innovation. Naam. Listen what As-Sa'di said. وَمِنْ أَعْظَمِ الْبِرِّ, from the greatest forms of good, is a sa'i fi jam'i kalimati al-muslimin, is striving to unite the Muslims. Bi kulli tariqin wa naqul wa nazid bi kulli tariqin mashru'. He said, from the greatest forms of righteousness, basing yani it upon the ayah wa ta'awanu ala al-bir, and cooperate upon righteousness. He said, one of the greatest forms of righteousness is striving to unite the Muslims and them agreeing upon the truth with every legislated means that is possible. نَحْنُ نَبْتَعِدْ مِنَ الْبِدْعَةِ وَالْمُبْتَدِعِينَ, we do not come close and we do not mingle with people of innovation, the innovators. لَا أَبَدًا, it doesn't mean that. It doesn't mean that يعني we associate with them. It cannot mean that, because Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Quran, He instructs us not to sit with the people of innovation. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the Sunnah, he warns us against sitting with the people of innovation. But what does it mean? It means implementing the legislated measures that bring about unity. عَلَى سَبِيلِ الْمِثَالِ, and I'll give some examples just for clarity. Spreading the salams. Spreading the salams, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it will cause us to love one another. Giving gifts, give gifts and you will love one another. Visiting the sick, and so on and so forth. Aiding your brother, aiding your sister in that which is ma'roof, that which is good. This is what it's referring to. And this is important, ikhwan, because it will bring us together and it will make us like one body. And when we have this strength, because of our unity upon the book and the sunnah with the understanding of the salaf, no one can stop us. Sheikh Muqbi used to say, rahimahullah, Sheikhuna, he said, we fear for our da'wah. The only thing that we fear is our own selves, our own souls, our own deficiencies and shortcomings. Because the people of innovation can never obstruct the call of Ahl Sunnah. It's only when يعني, us as individuals, we fail to implement that which we learn. May Allah Azza wa Jalla allow us to implement the book and the sunnah. As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, كَمَا أَنَّ السَّعِي فِي تَفْرِيقِ كَلِمَةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ أَعْظَمِ التَّعَاوَنْ عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, and likewise striving to cause disunity. And the Shaykh is referring to mother, to what? He's referring to spreading namima and ghiba, backbiting and tail carrying and jealousy and enmity and lying and so on and so forth. He said, striving to cause separation and division amongst the Muslims, the people upon the haq, is mada, is from the greatest forms of sinning and transgression. And the Shaykh, he said, Ikhwan, وَقَدْ قَصَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْنَا. Allah Azza wa Jal has informed us in the Quran concerning the biographies of the messengers. فِي كِتَابِهِ سِيرَةَ الرُّسُلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ الَّذِينَ بَعَثَهُمَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لِتَبْلِيغِ رِسَالَتِهِ. Those messengers whom Allah Azza wa Jal sent to convey His messages. And He said, وَذَكَرَ نُصْحَهُمْ. And Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned how they sincerely advised their people. لِأُمَمِهِمْ. And how they desired for their people to be united upon the religion of Al-Islam. And how they forbade their people from differing and splitting. And this is found in many places in the Quran. وَكَذَلِكَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And likewise the Prophet عَلَيْهِ سَلَاتُ وَالسَّلَامُ. He spoke concerning this foundation, unity upon the book and the sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. And he repeated it often. And he warned us against mada, splitting and differing. Al-mufdi ila al-fasad, which leads to corruption. And in the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, La tahasadu, do not be jealous of one another. Do not inflate the prices one to another. Do not hate one another. Do not turn your backs upon one another. وَكُونُوا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ إِخْوَانًا. Rather, you should be, O servants of Allah Azza wa Jal, you should be brothers. Al-Muslim, أَخَ الْمُسْلِمِ. The Muslim is the brother of another Muslim. He does not oppress him. He does not forsake him. Al-Hadith. Na'am, when your brother needs you, that is when you're meant to come forward. How can we know our friends? At times of need. True friends. When our brother is in need, we assist him. من غير سؤال, without them asking. هكذا. السعدي رحمه الله, he said, وفي صحيح مسلم عن تميم الداري رضي الله تعالى عنه. He said, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, الدين النصيحة, the religion is advice. We said to whom, O Messenger of Allah? He said, to Allah, لله ولكتابه, and to his book, ولرسوله, and to his messenger, and to the rulers, the leaders of the Muslims and the common folk. Listen what As-Sa'di rahimahullah, he said, وَمِنْ أَعْظَمِ النَّصِيحَةِ. From the greatest forms of advice is مَاذَا لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ. For the Muslims is to strive to unite and join their hearts. Barakallahu feekum. And how is this achieved? By teaching them the Quran and the Sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. Not watering the religion down. Not watering the religion down. Not compromising over the deen. Not remaining silent about falsehood. La. If you look at, for example, the scholars of Al-Islam in every age and era, you find that they work towards this unity by teaching the people. By teaching them the Quran and the Sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. And by warning against shirk, calling to tawheed. Calling to Sunnah, warning against bid'ah. Calling to obedience, warning against disobedience. This is how they work for unity. May Allah Azza wa Jalla allow us to imitate them. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. السعدي رحمه الله إخواني continues. He said, وكان صلى الله عليه وسلم يوصي. He said the Prophet ﷺ would advise those individuals who he would send out to give da'wah, to call to the religion of Al-Islam and to teach yani the legislation of the religion. He would advise them with what? He would say to them, Bashiru wala tunafiru. Give yani glad tidings and do not chase people away. Bashiru wala tunafiru. Give glad tidings and do not chase people away. Yassiru wala tu'assiru. Make things easy and do not make things hard. Hakadha. Likewise, وقال, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا تختلفوا فتختلف قلوبكم. Do not differ as your hearts will differ. Naam, even ikhwan, and this is a clear dalil, that if we abandon the sunnah, even if it relates to straightening the rows and closing the gaps, if we abandon this sunnah, it will lead to differing. Differing mother of what? The differing of the qalb. That's why the sunnah can never be taken lightly. And we hear statements where people say, it doesn't matter. لا يهمك. It doesn't matter. لا يهمك. هذا لا يفقه السنة. That person doesn't understand the sunnah or the way of Ahl Sunnah. How can he? When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, لا تختلفوا. Do not differ, as Allah Azza wa Jalla will cause your heart to differ. So Sa'di, he said, فَأَخْبَرَ أَنَّ الْإِخْتِلَافَ الظَّاهِرِ سَبَبْ لِإِخْتِلَافِ الْبَاطِنِ. That differing, يعني apparently and physically, that even in the prayer when lining up, not straightening the rows, and joining and closing the gaps, being separate in this fashion, and differing in this way, it can lead to what? The differing of the qalb, the heart. Even sitting, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes in the hadith in Sunan Abi Dawud, when he saw the companions sitting separately in the valley, what did he say? He instructed them to come together. And he said, sitting separately like this is from the actions of the devil. Why? Because sitting separately in different gatherings, it leads to disunity and it leads to splitting. Showing us, ikhwan, that there is no unity except upon what? Upon the book and the sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. True unity. The unity that matters. The unity that will benefit us as individuals in this life. And as communities in this life. And likewise, most importantly, the akhirah. Some people, they just want unity for the sake of the dunya. هذا ما ينفع ولا يغني من جوع. As-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, ikhwan, mentioning various ahadith concerning al-ikhtilaf, differing and splitting. He said, and whoever studies this and contemplates upon it would surely understand, أن هذا الأصل من أعظم معروف. This foundation, the foundation of unity, unity upon the haqq, is from the greatest forms of good which we are commanded with. And being يعني, وإضاعته, and being negligent concerning it, and lackadaisical concerning it, and not showing it its due importance, is from the greatest forms of evil that we have been prohibited from. He said, وَأَنَّ هَذَا مِنْ فُرُودِ الْأَعْيَانِ. This is an obligation upon everyone, ikhwan. اللازم لكل الأمة, which is obligatory upon the whole of the ummah, the scholars, the rulers, and even the common people. Naam, this is upon everyone, ikhwan. Don't just think that this is upon ماذا, upon the ulama, or upon specific groups of people. Everyone has a role to play in this. Because if we implement the sunnah, inshallah, we'll bring unity. If we abandon the sunnah, it will lead to what? Disunity. هذا مهم جدا إخوان. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to unite our hearts upon the book and the sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. We ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to forgive us of our shortcomings and to rectify our affairs. And before I close, إخوان, barakallahu feekum, the brothers have requested that I make a very important and likewise beneficial announcement. And this is concerning the position of Imam in this masjid. Alhamdulillah, the Imam of this masjid, bi'idhnillahi tabaraka wa ta'ala, will be our brother Talib Abdullah, hafidhahullahu ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, hada yusirruna. This is something that should make us happy. This is something, inshallah ta'ala, that should please us. And this is something, alhamdulillah, that is an encouragement for us. An encouragement for what? An encouragement for us to busy ourselves with that which is beneficial for us as individuals and likewise our families. Because sometimes we just get caught up in the hype. Sometimes we get diverted by things which are not really beneficial. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, yani worry about things that are beneficial to you. على ما ينفعك. Worry about those things that are beneficial for you. So the brother, inshallah ta'ala, will be teaching, leading the salawat and dealing with the affairs, inshallah ta'ala, of the masjid. And alhamdulillah, this is an opportunity likewise for the community as a whole, again, to support the efforts, inshallah ta'ala, which are based upon that which is correct, and to support, inshallah ta'ala, the efforts of the ikhwah who are trying to benefit you as individuals, and likewise the community as a whole. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he informed us in the authentic sunnah about the relationship that we have to one another. We are like one body. We are like one body. Imagine if your foot decided one day, khalas, yani the foot, it doesn't move. It's not going to, yani, to move at all. What's going to happen? You're going to collapse. So likewise, if someone's sitting there with the mentality that, you know, I don't care, hadha ma yuhimmani, that's not important to me, or so on and so forth, that's counterproductive and that's not in accordance to the teachings of the book and the sunnah. And lastly, ikhwan, just a piece of advice, alhamdulillah, that Sheikh Ubaid ibn Abdullah gave us yesterday, which was very important. He said, I advise the brothers to busy themselves teaching the people the Quran and the sunnah, to busy themselves benefiting the individuals, yani, of the community and the people in general. Teach them the Quran and the sunnah with the understanding of the Salaf. As for that which is not beneficial, the Shaykh, he advised us to leave it alone. And alhamdulillah, there are other wasaya, other pieces of advice. That which is munasib, inshallah, appropriate, I will share with you, inshallah ta'ala, after some of the salawat. And maybe if we get an opportunity to complete the book or the treatise of Al-Imam Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, we will do so. Wa aqim as-salah.